Hi, I'm Yulia Kasarenko, and you're watching the Why Change channel. Our topic this time is data and whether it's important for business analysis. This topic comes up more and more often, and no surprise. Organizations create data at neck-breaking speed, and often it results in more data than they can manage. Did you know, for example, that more than 80% of all data generated today is big data? What's big data? What do you do with it? This is exactly why we need to have more conversations about it. Every business application, device, website, social media platform generates data that can be used or abused. Without intelligent data management practices, organizations are not able to take advantage of their data and eventually may lose any competitive advantage they've had. They can even fall victim to hacking attempts or ransomware. And these are not only concerns for security experts or data architects. Business analysts play a central role in defining requirements for organizational changes. And it's not possible to do that without considering data. Data connects business processes and the parts of organization to create an integrated enterprise. Every single business change involves changing business data, creating new data, sharing it, using it to make decisions or to store information for future use. We cannot analyze business processes and disregard the data that these processes will use or update. We need data to develop the right products, to connect to our customers at the right time, to run the business effectively. We need data to detect process inefficiencies, learn the patterns of customer behavior, and understand, or even better, predict their needs. And just as importantly, organizations need to use data to make business decisions. If you truly want to help your clients solve business problems, you need to focus on helping them make better decisions based on clean, consistent, conformed, current, and comprehensive data. This means producing useful business analytics insights. And to do that, we need business analysis to understand the problem that needs to be solved, what data is required to produce the insights, and to properly define analytics requirements. So a business analyst needs to understand the fundamentals of data management and data analysis to provide value to modern data-driven enterprises. In this video, I will share with you what business analysts need to know about data. First, the basics. What is data? In what form it exists, where it can be stored, and how it may be structured. Then, the types of data. You need to understand the difference between structured and unstructured data, and while we are at it, what is semi-structured data. The methods and technology for handling structured and unstructured data can be quite different. In particular, we cannot use those traditional methods such as relational databases to store and manage unstructured data. Next, you must be able to distinguish quantitative and qualitative data and be clear about the difference between nominal and ordinal categorical data. What is discrete data and what is continuous, numeric or text? How can we capture dates and times? Is there a difference between a flag and a code? And what exactly does it mean, XML data? Next, as a business analyst, you need to understand the data life cycle. What happens with data as it gets created, moves around, is transformed, restructured, used, shared, and eventually destroyed. At every stage of the data life cycle, there needs to be requirements related to managing the data. For example, how to ensure that the data entered by end users is valid and accurate? How can we validate data inputs? How can we share data from one business system to another? And what happens if these systems have different definitions and data structures? How can your organization use external data to its advantage? For example, customer reviews collected on social media or consumer research from third parties. What data do you need to ensure customers receive accurate notifications about their orders or product updates? What data needs to be protected, encrypted? And what data about your customer you should destroy at a certain point to reduce the risk of exposure, both for the customer and for your company? When you start to analyze these requirements for managing, using, and sharing data, you will discover that you also need additional tools and techniques to help you. This could be creating data models to help capture the main concepts and relationships between them. An ability to create a conceptual data model is a very valuable skill and can help you in your own professional growth. Understanding how data is structured in relational databases, what are data entities, relationships, and attributes, would be key if you were to work on a data warehouse in a business intelligence project. Basic SQL knowledge can make you a powerhouse on your team. Imagine what you could do if you were able to explore and query data to validate various scenarios, detect exceptional flows, or resolve arguments between stakeholders with production data in hand. Another important skill is ability to describe the data. Every term, data entity, and attribute needs to be defined. You may have done the basic version of it as a glossary. From there, if you can define the data type for each attribute, what are the valid values and business rules, you can contribute to a data dictionary. This is necessary to promote consistent use of data across the enterprise, to start governing the data. Senior business analysts are often key contributors to their organization's data governance efforts. And if you can create a data dictionary, then you could also work on data mapping to support the integration requirements. Every business application these days is integrated with at least one and sometimes many others. Integration requires that the data from one system, the source, is mapped to the data in the target system, to ensure correct data transit and transformation. Someone has to do the mapping. When it is inaccurate or incomplete, this becomes a frequent reason for integration failures. When a business analyst has a good understanding of business data, its sources, and the rules about managing it, this knowledge will be invaluable for accurate data mapping. And if you know how to do it and have practical experience, your value as a professional, again, will also grow. Of course, this is not the end. A business analyst that masters these fundamental data management skills can contribute to develop their competencies even further. Data exploration, analysis, and visualization, analytics, and business intelligence are all key capabilities that data-driven enterprises are keen to develop. As a business analyst, you have the foundation to support these capabilities and grow professionally as you learn more and more about data management, governance, and analytics. I will include some links in the video description if you would like to learn more. For organizations, please take a look at the corporate training offerings on my website, y-change.com, or contact me directly. And if you are a business analyst, remember the 12th principle of the BA mindset: learn, adapt, and thrive. Thank you very much for watching, and until next time, this is Why Change Channel. Bye-bye.